when we got appointed, one of the honest things I must say was I didn't know anything about what a minister of communication does. And the first thing I had to do was to get through the handover report, understand the mandate in terms of the acts, different pieces of legislation, the constitution, and finally come to pick up the work that has been done over time through the annual plans and the medium-term strategic framework of the government. Out of that, one of the critical things was about building and reaching out to stakeholders in the communication sector. And as we went around interacting, we came to realize that there is something that is missing. And there is a need for that. And I want to first start with what happened last year with the print colloquium. That was the one that was held in August. And I found that it was actually a wrong move. Because the minute you separate and you don't create an opportunity for everyone to contribute and appreciate the need to complement one another, you actually perpetuate silos. And I think that was one of the things that I picked up. And in realizing that, then a need arose that for us to be able to deal with everything that has to do with this particular sector, let's bring everybody under one roof. But let's also have a build-up towards what is happening here today. And we have had different interactions with the different entities and the other organizations and bodies that are quite strategic for this sector. This we felt it is quite important. Why is it important? It is important because part of what we need to do is to ensure that in everything that we seek to do, we must contribute towards sustainability, integrity, coordination, effectiveness, and efficiency. And that can't actually happen in silos. And I do believe, therefore, that one of the things that would have to happen is to ensure that all that has been done must then feed into the product of these last 2 days, including possibly an enriched input that came even from those that were participants in the last year's colloquium. So that then we are able to say, this is the future we want, this is the future that we envisage, and of importance, this is the way towards efficiency and effectiveness and less of dependency and reliance. So that we cease from seeking to be part of an institution that ordinarily we need not be part of it. It has a responsibility to create an enabling environment for our existence, but we have a responsibility to sustain our presence. And that is the reason. So that at the end of the day, we do not have an extension of a government, but we have a service that is rendered, we have a means that exists, and we have the capacity that exists through the structures and the sectors that you all are coming from. And why is it important for us? It is important because in line with that long-term vision of the Republic of South Africa, which is the National Development Plan, we have a critical role in growing the economy, in ensuring that there's inclusive growth, and most importantly, in contributing to an equal society, particularly in the sector that is yet to be transformed. Because again, we all know that the communication sector is one of those sectors that is yet to be transformed, but it is also a sector that has not adhered to some of the means of driving transformation in South Africa, such as the adherence to the BEE policy of 2003. So, what is to be done? What we have to do is to first understand our primary existence. Our primary existence is that of making sure that We realize that dream of the young girl Tandeka, that the former minister who was responsible for driving the National Development Plan actually alluded to say, what kind of a South Africa we want in 2030 and what do we expect from Tandeka in 2030. Our input should be towards contributing in the following areas. On the economic front, secondly, we must contribute towards nation building and social cohesion. We have to contribute towards the skills development as well as the diversification of the means of communication in our country. We need to make sure that we contribute to equality in our country in terms of dealing with racial polarization and racial divisions and ownership, but also in dealing with issues of divisions on the basis of gender and gender inequalities with regard to ownership, with regard to content, and most importantly, with regard to participation in the sector. And we should strive towards also getting into the established part of the communication sector so that we do not remain the ones that are small, the ones that are perceived to be dependent, but we must also begin to tamper with the establishment. And tamper with the establishment such that the environment is through a process that we create. We create through what? Through ICASA, through CENTEC, so that then there can be an emergence of alternatives. And that can happen when government deals with the issues that you have raised around the spectrum, you deal with the issues around the credibility and accountability that has been raised in terms of compliance by yourself. So all of us, we have a responsibility for you to succeed, but you must remember, you have determined your existence. And having determined your existence, you must refuse to be an appendage. We need to make sure that we must be seen as a sector of choice, of relevance, and most importantly, of value. And that is part of the deliberations. And I think just picking up from the feedback that was made now, including the intention, amongst other things that we definitely have to deal with is that appreciation that we need to make sure that we have the ability to justify our presence and we have the capability to continue existing. But of importance, we have a responsibility to account.